بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Math grade 6. We are in model 5, numerical and algebraic expressions. Today we have the last lesson in this chapter. We have lesson 7, equivalent algebraic expressions. Equivalent algebraic expressions. In this lesson, we want to learn how to identify and generate equivalent algebraic expressions. Prepare your notebook, please. The question now, evaluate each expression. Evaluate each expression. We have 5 plus 2 times between parentheses 3x1 and 2 minus 1. I want to, from all, you have 2 minutes to try to evaluate this expression and tell me your answer, please. Start.
Mr. I'm Alia. Is the answer 21?
Great, Alia, thank you. Who has a different answer?
Mr.
Yes, Sheikha?
Is that answer 21?
21, okay, thank you, Sheikha, great work. Who has different answer? Okay, check with me, please. As you see here, we have parentheses, we have power, we have minus, we have multiply, we have plus. The order of operations for the parentheses. So rewrite the expression. We have 5 plus 2. Now, inside the parentheses, we have 3x1 and 2. Do the power. 3x1 and 2 means 3 times 3 means 9 minus 1. Now here we have 5, rewrite now, 5 plus 2 times 9 minus 1 will be 8. Then we have here 5 plus 2 times 8 will be 16. 5 plus 16 will be 21. Okay, now I want from all to try to solve number 2 and tell me your answer, please.
Where is the answer 11?
Great, Nagam, thank you. Who has different answer? Okay, listen, please. The order for the parentheses. So rewrite the expression. We have here 12 minus 3. Inside the parenthesis, 3 plus 3 will be 6. Divide by 6.
Mr. I'm sorry, but is the answer is 11?
Thank you, Alia. Yes. Okay, now we have subtraction and we have division. The order for the division. So we can write here 12. Minus 6 divided by 6 will be 1. Now 12 minus 1 will be 11. Okay, now exercise number 3, but here the question, evaluate each expression for x, or for here we have wrong in this question, expression when x equal 5, when x equal 5. Start to evaluate number 3. We have 2x plus 1, and the value of x will be 5.
The answer?
Yes. The answer is yes. Okay, thank you, Naam. Who has different answer?
Mr. I agree with Naam.
Great. Who has different answer?
Mr. I agree with Naam.
Great. Okay, listen to me, please. Hello. The name of this step, substitute. Substitute. What is the meaning of substitute? Take the value of x and put it Here. Here we have 2x. What's the meaning of 2x? 2 times x. Substitute. What is the value of x? X equal 5. So put here 5. This is the meaning of substitute. Plus 1. So 2 times x will be 10. 10 plus 1 will be 11. Now the same idea, try to solve or to evaluate exercise number 4.
Where is the answer 22?
Great, Nada. Who has different answer?
Mister, my answer is 22.
Great, Alia, thank you. Who has different answer?
Mister, my answer is 22.
Great, Moza. Okay, listen to me. We want to evaluate this expression when the value of x equal 5. So the first step, substitute. What's the meaning of substitute? Put the value of the variable, x. So here we have parentheses. We have here x. The value of x will be 5. So write here 5 plus 2. Then we have here plus 3x, means 3 times the value of x, substitute. Put the value of x will be 5. So 5 plus 2 will be 7. Then 3 times 5 will be 15. So 7 plus 15 will be 22. Right. Now, who can read exercise number 5, please?
Nagam, can I read it, please?
Yes.
Walter earned $15 for every yard he mowed, but he spent $10 on a book. Using X for a variable that represents the number of lawns mowed, write an algebraic expression for the amount of money Walter has left.
Great. Hello. Do you know how many yards did he have?
No.
So this is variable X. But he earned $15 every yard. So times 15 to know the cost. But spent. Spent means what? Minus. Spent means minus $12 on a book. So minus 12. So this is the equation. This is the equation. So he write an algebraic expression for amount of money Walter has left. So this is the expression. This is the expression. But check with me now the answers. Here 21, here 11, here 11, here 21, here 15x minus 12. Okay, thank you for your work. So what is our lesson today? Our lesson today, equivalent expressions, equivalent expressions. The first idea now, we want to learn the property of equivalent expressions. The first property, commutative property. What's the meaning of commutative property? The order in which number are added or multiplied does not change the sum or product. For example, 7 plus 9, is it equal 9 plus 7? Yes. Because here 7 plus 9 will be 16, and 9 plus 7 will be 16. As a variable, we can write a plus b equal b plus a. This is the meaning of commutative property for addition. And for multiplication, if I write 8 times 4 and 4 times 8, is it 8 times 4 equal 4 times 8? Yes. Because 8 times 4 will be 32 and 4 times 8 will be 32. Type. As a variables, we can write a times b equal b times a. This is the meaning of commutative. The second property, associative property. Associative property. What's the meaning of associative property? The word in which numbers are grouped when added or multiplied does not change the sum of or product. As you see here, if we have three amounts, three numbers, 3 + 4 + 7, and I grouped the two numbers between parentheses, 4 and 7. Then I use the same three numbers here, but I change the place of the parentheses. Is it the same result or a change in the result? As you see here, 4 + 7 will be 11. 11 + 3 will be 14. So here 14. But here 3 + 7 + 4 = 7. 7 + 7 will be 14. The same answer. So we don't have, doesn't change. We don't have any change. The same result. This is the meaning of associative property. This is for addition. So I can write A plus between parentheses B plus C equal between parentheses A plus B plus C. And for addition, the same idea. If I have three numbers, 7 × 6 × 2, and I group 6 and 2 between parentheses. And if I change the parentheses, the place of parentheses between the numbers, for example, here put 7 and 6 between parentheses, I notes here the same answer. We have the same answer. So I can write as a variables, A times between parentheses B times C equal between parentheses A times B times C. This is the meaning of associative property, associative property. Now, the lesson of yesterday, distributive property, distributive property. To multiply a sum by a number, multiply each addend by the number outside the parentheses. Right. When we have two, multiply between parentheses 7 + 9, I can use distribute. Take 2, multiply by 7, 2 times 7, plus, then take 2, multiply by 9. So I can write A times between parentheses B plus C. We can write A times B plus A times C. Now, if we have subtraction, so we can distribute 4 times 5, then minus 4 times 2. So as a variable, A times B minus C equal A times B minus A times C. The last property, identity property. What's the meaning of identity property? The sum of an addend, and 0 is the addend, the product of a factor, and 1 is the factor. So 13 + 0 = 13. As you know, each number plus 0 equals the same number. This is the meaning of identity for addition. So we can use as a variable, we can write A plus 0 equal A. And for addition, 7 times 1 will be 7. As you know, any number multiplied by 1 equals the same number. So this is the meaning of the identity for multiplication. So we can write A times 1 equal 8. So this is the properties. Now, what's the meaning of equivalent expressions? What's the meaning of equivalent expressions? If we have two expressions or more, and the all expressions have the same value, the name of all expressions here, equivalent expressions. So, the question here, use the properties of operations to determine whether or not. Is it 3 multiplied between parentheses x plus 7 plus 2 and 5 plus 3 times between parentheses x plus 6? are equivalent or not. طيب. We want to check together. The first expression here, we have 3 multiplied by x plus 7 plus 2. I want to simplify the first expression. Type. What I can do here in this expression, as you see here, we have multiply by parentheses, and between parentheses, inside the parentheses, we have addition. So we can use the distributive property. Take 3 multiplied by x, 3 times x will be 3x plus. Here we have 7. Take 3 multiplied by 7. 3 times 7 will be 21. Then we have plus 2. So the name of the first property, distributive property. We use distributive property. Like the second step, add the like terms. Add the like terms. What is the like terms? We have 21 and 2. So we can group between parentheses. What is the name of this property? Associative. Associative. Now we can add it. 3x plus 21 plus 2 will be 23. I cannot add 3x to the 23 because here we have alike terms. Because here we have alike terms. This is the first expression. Then take the next expression. We have 5 plus 3 multiply between parentheses x plus 6. So what I can do to simplify this expression, as you see here, we can use distributive property. Rewrite the expression. We can write here 5 plus, then take 3 multiply by x. 3 times x will be 3x. Then take 3 multiply by 6. 3 times x will be 18. Then use the associative property to add the like terms. We have here 5 and 18. So we can write 3x plus, we can put between parentheses, 5 plus 18. Plus 5 plus 18 will be 23. Type. As you see, the answer here 3x plus 23, and the answer here 3x plus 23. Type. If the two expressions have the same value, what is the name of the two expressions here? Equivalent. The name of the expressions here, what? Equivalent. This is the meaning of the equivalent. This is the meaning of the equivalent.
Mr. وش معنى الx?
الx يعني الفاريبل القيمة الغير معلومة الغير قيمة الغير معروفة نسميها فاريبل نسميها فاريبل.
Mr. I didn't understand the last idea.
Okay. الإكويفلنت يعني بسمي أنا الإكسبريشنز إكويفلنت إذا كان لهم نفس الجواب لهم نفس القيمة بس يكون لهم نفس القيمة شو بنسميهم؟ بنسميهم إكويفلنت هي معناها الإكويفلنت فأنا إذا أعطاني تو إكسبريشنز أعطاني تركيبين جبريين وقال لي سألني إنه هن إكويفلنت ولا لا فبروح شوف أنا إذا كان لهم نفس القيمة نفس الجواب جاوبه بقول له إكويفلنت أما إذا كان لهم جواب مختلف شو بنقول له؟ not equivalent فلاحظوا معي هالمثال الآن use the properties of operations to determine whether or not we have here the first expression here we have 0.6m plus 0 and we have 0.6m are equivalent if so what property can be applied to determine that they are equivalent طيب انتو as you see 0.6m plus 0 equal what equal 0.6m means equal the same value of the next expression? Means equivalent or not?
Equivalent.
Equivalent type. Do you know what is the name of this property? Is it associative or commutative or distributive or identity or not equivalent?
Identity.
Property. Yes, identity. So I can choose here equivalent and identity property. Great. Watch this video, please.
مستر
هو البراجع عند الحساب
مستر صوتك يعلق يا مستر من عندي هي خمسة هني شوف
نعم يا رب تفضل
لا بس كان يعلق صوتك فقلت لك اوكي
طيب listen to this example. The question here, use substitution to determine whether or not 2x plus x plus x and 4x are equivalent or not. Here we have two expressions. The first expression we have 2x plus x plus x. This is the first expression. And the value of x equal 1. Here we have three values for x, 0 and 1 and 2. I will choose 1 for example. Now substitute. What's the meaning of substitute? Put the value of x equal 1. So 2x means 2 times 1. 2x means 2 times 1 plus x means 1 plus x means 1. No, 2 times 1 will be 2. Plus 1, plus 1. 2 times 1 will be 3, plus 1 will be 4. So the value of the first expression will be what? Will be 4. Now take the next expression, 4x. What the meaning of 4x? Substitute means 4 times the value of x. The value of x will be what? Will be 1. So write here 1. 4 times 1 will be 4. Now as you see, we have the same result. Here 4, here 4. And if the two expressions have the same result, means the two expressions here what? Equivalent. Equivalent. This is the meaning of the equivalent. I will take the attendance, then we will continue together, please. Aliasia?
Yes, Mr.
Rauda, Nasir? Rauda? Rauda, Nasir?
Mr. Rauda, I'm here, but I'm not going to put the mic.
أنا نبهت من أول الحصة ما هيك؟ نبهت قلت بأي لحظة بدي أخذ التفقد الإبدادي ما بيرد معناتها ما هو موجود. روضة ناصر. شمسة فيصل.
Yes, Mr.
شيخ أحمد.
Yes.
عليا خالد.
Yes, Mr.
لطيفة.
نعم, Mr.
مريم فوزي.
نعم مستر.
موزة.
يس مستر.
نغم.
يس مستر.
نورة.
يس مستر.
هاجر.
نعم مستر.
أقدر أنه ممكن أخذ التفقد مرة ثانية. طيب نرجع للدرس الآن.
ويت مستر في قلبك اسمها روضة عيني.
عفوا ما نادينا اسمك لانه مو نازل اسمك بالقوائم. طيب روضة.
نعم مستر.
Can you spell it your surname, please?
Mr. I have her name spelling.
Yes.
Her name is A-L-N-U.
Yes.
A-I-M-I.
Thank you.
You're
welcome. Rawda, امبارح ما كنتي موجودة نعيمي ولا كنتي موجودة yesterday. روضة. روضة النعيمي. كنت موجودة البارحة ولا ما كنتي؟
كانت موجودة مستر.
موجودة طيب. Okay, listen to this example. Use substitution to determine whether or not 2y plus 2 plus 1 and 3 plus y plus 2y are equivalent or not. طيب. Take the first expression. We have 2y plus 2 plus 1.
Mr. I'm sorry, but can I go to the toilet?
Okay.
Thank you.
So what I can do here, add the like terms. So we can use associative property. So we can write here 2y plus 2 plus 1 will be 3. Then the second expression, we have 3 plus.
Can I drink water, please?
Yes. 3 plus y plus 2y. Then we can add the like terms here. Use associative property. So we can write here y plus 2y will be 3y plus 3. Now notice here. They have the different answer. Here we have 2y plus 3, and here we have 3y plus 3. So equivalent or not equivalent? Equivalent or not equivalent?
Mr. Mathaham, okay.
Not equivalent. Not equivalent. إذا لأنه أعطاني جواب مختلف. هي شو أعطاني جوابها 2y plus 3. بينما هي شو أعطاني جوابها 3y plus 3. فأعطاني جواب مختلف. وقت بيكون الجواب مختلف معناته شو؟ Not equivalent. معناته شو قرر أنا not equivalent.
كيف مستر تعرف أن الجواب مش نفسه؟
شرحناها بشوي، ركزي معي الله يرضى عليك. طيب نرجع من عيد. هلا اول اكسبريشن يا لطيفه هو هذا، لاحظي 2y بلس 2 بلس 1. اذا اول اكسبريشن عندي 2y بلس 2 بلس 1. طيب شو ممكن نساوي هون انا يا لطيفه؟ بجمع الحدود المتشابهه. هلا ال2 مثل ال1 فبحطهم ضمن قوسين بهذا الشكل، واسمها هي الخاصه لنا اسوشيتيف. طيب معناتها صار عندي الان 2y بلس، هلا 2 بلس 1، 2 بلس 1 شو بيعطيني؟ بيعطيني 3. اذا شو الجواب هون اعطاني هلا 2y بلس 3. بقدر اعمل لهم بلس لهدول ال2 y مع ال3؟ لا. ليش؟ لانه اسمهم unlike terms، حدود مختلفة. هذا الحد يختلف عن هذا الحد، ما بقدر اجمعه. إذا هذا آخر جواب 2y plus 3. هلا باخذ الاكسبريشن الثاني اللي هو 3 plus y plus 2y. طيب شو بقدر اساوي هون؟ كمان بقدر اجمع الحدود المتشابهة. Add the like terms. مين الحدود المتشابهة اللي فيها y؟ هي فيها y وهي فيها y، فبحطهم ضمن قوسين والخاصة اسمها associated. الآن صار في عندي y plus 2y، y يعني 1y، y يعني 1y، 1 plus 2 يعني 3y، وهون شو في عندي 3 plus 3. طيب هلا بنقارن بين الإجابات، إذا الإجابات مثل بعض بنقول عنهم equivalent، إذا الإجابات مختلفة شو بنقول عنهم؟ not equivalent. قارني يا لطيفة، هون عندك 2y بلس 3، هون عندك 3y بلس 3. معناتها قلن نفس الجواب ولا مختلفين في الأجوبة؟ جاوبيني. طلعي مني، هون 2y بلس 3، هون 3y بلس 3. نفس بعض ولا مختلفين؟ لاحظي هون 2 هون 3 مختلفين. هذا أعطاني جواب مختلف عن هذا. طيب إذا الأجوبة مختلفة معناتها بقول equivalent ولا not equivalent؟
Not equivalent.
فلذلك شو قلنا هون؟ Not equivalent. تمام؟
تمام.
Mr. When are you going to give us the our account and password in Magro Hill?
والله انا ما عندي الحسابات، بدكم تتواصلوا مع الاستاذ احمد، الاستاذ احمد على اساس يتواصل مع المايكرو هيل ويرجعوا يبعثوا لنا مره ثانيه، هن عم يقولوا انه بعثوا لكم اياها من الفصل الاول. انا ما حدا بعث شيء.
في الفصل الاول بس سوينا سند حق الساينس بس.
تبع الماس.
هاي مس ديانا طرشت لي اياها انا.
طيب خلص تواصلوا مع المس ديانا معناتها. اللي بده الباسورد للمايكرو هيل للماث يتواصل مع المس ديانا او الاستاذ احمد حتى ياخذ اليوزر نيم والباسورد. انا ما عندي اياهم، ما زودوني فيهم يعني. طيب the question now، use substitution to determine whether or not. هلا في عندي هون 1 over 2x plus x squared plus 1 over 2. And here we have 1 over 2x plus 3x squared plus 1 over 2 minus x squared. طيب خلي يكون معي وركزوا معي هون. The first expression we have 1 over 2x plus x squared plus 1 over 2. And the value of x, for example, equals 0. Now substitute. What's the meaning of substitute? Put the value of x. Here we have 1 over 2. Times x, the value of x will be 0 plus, we have here x squared, the value of x will be 0, exponent 2 plus 1 over 2. 0 times 1 over 2 will be 0, and 0 squared, 0 exponent 2 means 0 times 0 will be 0. And here we have 1 over 2. Now 0 plus 0 plus 1 over 2, the answer will be what? Will be 1 over 2. Now this is the first expression. This is the first expression. Now take the second expression. We have 1 over 2 x plus 3x exponent 2 or 3x squared. Plus 1 over 2 minus x squared minus x squared. And the value of x will be what? Will be 0. So substitute, substitute means put the value of x. So here we have 1 over 2 multiply by x, multiply by 0, plus 3x squared means 3 times the value of x will be 0 squared, then plus 1 over 2, plus 1 over 2, minus x squared means 0 squared, 0 exponent 2. Now 0 times half will be 0. So this term 0. 0 times 3 will be 0. Plus 1 over 2. Minus 0 exponent 2. 0 exponent 2 means 0 times 0 means 0. So 1 over 2 minus 0 will be 1 over 2. So as you see, here we have 1 over 2 and here we have 1 over 2. The same result, the same answer. So the two expressions here, equivalent or not equivalent?
Equivalent.
Great. This is our lesson today.
I have a question before the class finish.
Okay.
Do we have a revision for the test on Thursday?
Okay, just wait with me. So, what is the name of our lesson today?
Equivalent.
Equivalent expression. Equivalent expression. Equivalent. What's the meaning of the equivalent expressions?
There's an equivalent just like and not equivalent. And just like not equivalent, just like they are not just like the same answer. And if that's equivalent, so they are the same answer.
When I have two expressions or more have the same value, the name of this expression is equivalent. The name of this expression is equivalent. What's the meaning of substitute?
Means
use the value of the variable. Use the value of the variable inside the expression to know the value of this expression. Okay, so this is our lesson today. Thank you for your listening. Have a nice day. See you tomorrow, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.